In this video, we're going to walk through some of the tips and tricks for using Posit Cloud that I think will be helpful in both 1.5 intro to R and intro to data in R with cars. So we're going to look at both reading in a file. In this case, I'm going to have you read in an Excel sheet or creating a file from data that you get with the built-in data sets that are incorporated into R. So empty cars and iris are just two examples of data sets that a lot of people use for tutorials because you don't have to import any file. They're just built into the programming language. Whether or not you use Posit or RStudio is completely up to you. If you're using Posit or RStudio, one thing I think will really help your organization in this class is to use projects. So Posit kind of forces you to do this. Anytime you go to the website, you have to create a new project to get started working. On your computer, it is possible to open individual R scripts and files, but I don't think it's a good idea. I think that if you're working in RStudio, you should go to File, New Project, and create a brand new clean folder and a new directory for every single unit of the course. So you're only going to need four folders throughout the whole semester to do this. Make sure that you save those folders on the desktop or in your documents in a place that's easy to navigate to. And then when you create that project called Unit One Workspace or Unit One Project, you're going to be able to, if you're on your computer, double-click on the project icon to open up your workspace and get exactly back to where you were before. It just keeps things a lot more organized to work in this way and keep everything in folders. And it will really help you make sure that the files you need for input are all available within your workspace. Once you're in RStudio or Posit, there are four different panes that show up in the window. So on the lower right, you'll see all the files that are in that folder. This includes both R scripts and .rmd markdown files. I am completely agnostic about which type of file you use for this undergrad bioinformatics class. I slightly prefer markdowns myself because they break up the script into easy to test code chunks, but some people prefer to have everything be in one place without disruption, and so the .r file can work too. When you make a .r file, you have two ways to run individual lines of code, and anything you run will show up on the console, and any variables you create will show up in the environment. Before I run scripts, I always make a habit of removing objects from the environment with the clean sweep icon and removing any previously run commands from the console with the same icon. Once I'm ready to run a single line, I don't have to highlight the line. If I just have my mouse on the line, I can click Run, or on my keyboard, I can hit Control Enter. Either of those will run the data and allow me to run those commands. So when I run data empty cars, it doesn't actually create the variable in the environment until I use it somehow. And you can use it lots of different ways. I'll show you in the markdown script. I'm actually going to run a different command to load it. You can also see there's a variable, a simple variable that's just a value. So it's not actually a data frame. It's just a single value. The variable A is equal to 4. If you do have a data frame with this blue circle icon next to it, you can click on it and you can open it up and see that it looks like a spreadsheet. MT stands for Motor Trend. So these are all real cars that were described in Motor Trend magazine in an old issue. And these are all the stats that were provided for the individual types of cars. You can do the exact same thing that I just did in this script in a markdown file. So I'm going to actually delete the file I created just so you can see it get recreated. The difference is how it looks. So when you want to create a markdown file, you'll do File, New File, R Markdown, and it'll give you a template that has both descriptions. So these are going to show up as HTML headers if you do an HTML output. A setup code chunk. So this is where the library that's needed for the markdown file gets loaded. And then a spot for you to write any comments about your code chunks. Each of your code chunks can either be named squiggle bracket R or R with an extra name after it. If you use the extra name after it, you'll need to make that unique for each of the code chunks. Once you have your code chunk set up, you can run individual lines just like you did in the R script, or more conveniently, you can press these little play buttons that are available for each code chunk. So I cleared my environment, so empty cars wasn't in there anymore. When I run this code chunk, it does two things. It loads the data. So now I have that data frame back, that little spreadsheet of information about cars. And it runs this command summary that gives me all of the stats for each of the columns in the database. I can then scroll down and I can run the next code chunk to write a CSV file and create the file. You're gonna have to produce a CSV file for 1.5. And once you've made it on Posit Cloud, you'll need to download it onto your computer to be able to upload it to Canvas. You can do that by checking the box next to the file, going to More, Export, and download the file onto your computer. Similarly, for the first assignment for 1.5, you're gonna need to upload files. So if you click the Upload button, you can choose a local file and you can upload the Excel sheet that is linked on Canvas and you can get it into your history so that it'll be able to read in to RStudio and be able to read in to an environment variable that you can then manipulate. This is a very powerful tool. It's one of the fastest ways to make beautiful plots and be able to quickly clean up data that you may read in from lots of different sources, lots of different databases of biological data. And if you run into any issues, I'm always happy to work through them with you one-on-one in office hours. But hopefully this little drive-through will help you with the navigation part as you transition from working in RStudio on your computer to Posit Cloud.